Number four in the Twitter etudes is called simply a flourish. Number five of the six Twitter etudes is called Why I Love the Oboe. The composer says this might be his favorite of the etudes, and I think it might be mine as well. He's used a theme and created two variations to form a complete, beautiful, small piece, all in 140 notes. It's pretty incredible. And I wrote my own lyrics to this, and I'd invite all of you to think of what your lyrics might be and why you love the oboe. And finally, number six, disjunct motion. Maybe being in quarantine has you feeling like you're being pulled in different directions. One part of you knows you should stay home, but really wants to go join your friends or be outdoors or go to a concert. Well, I think we all can relate to that right now. So disjunct motion is a really interesting use of extreme registers in the oboe. The composer has me playing low notes, followed immediately by high notes, and then again, low notes. And somehow we have a seamless melodic and harmonic idea that goes throughout this etude. Only 140 notes, again, as all of them. And I think it's quite special and brilliant. Number six, disjunct motion. I hope you enjoyed this presentation of John Burge's six Twitter etudes for solo oboe. And Gonzalez, my cat, also hopes you enjoyed it. He's glad that we're done because he doesn't like the oboe. I hope that everybody is safe and well. J'espère que vous vous portez bien, vous êtes sauf et sain, et vous nous manquez. We, all of us in the orchestra, miss you. I miss all of my colleagues very much, and I sincerely hope that we're all back in Southam Hall together, making music and enjoying music and celebrating something that can only be experienced together as a group. Until then, I bid you farewell, and please take good care and good health to all of you. Say bye. Bye-bye.